Today we are discussing this progress report on Iceland and its membership of the European Union. And I frankly think it is absurd that once they have decided that they don't want to continue the accession talks, we should be bringing up this again in this parliament. I believe and have always believed that the EU is not going to stand still and allow Iceland to get off the hook. I think they're going to continue to force the country to become a member of the European Union. And it is not because they are worried about the people in Iceland. It's actually because the EU has specific interests in having this country being a member of the European Union. And I will refer to a couple of them. Firstly, their fishing industry. As we all know, they have an important fishing industry, and it has been sort of empowered because the currents are bringing more fish population to the to their coasts. So that's becoming quite important, and the EU is obviously very interested in getting their hands on it. And the other aspect that is of interest to the European Union is the fact that Iceland is part of this Arctic Council and is joined there by a number of countries, including Russia and the United States. If Iceland would become part of the European Union, of course, this would give the European Union access to this very privileged, I would say, club. I don't see that the EU is going to allow them to stay independent. And that's why at the end of August I went to Iceland to speak at the university, and I also spoke at the at a convention organized by the independent party there. And I tried to explain to them that, you know, it was not really in their interest to join the European Union, that they could do have the good part of the union, having an arrangement like Norway or Switzerland have, but they don't need to join this union. I explained, obviously, my history within the Union and as Chief Accountant of the European Commission. And I think I convinced a lot of people that they shouldn't reinitiate the accession talks. The country went through a serious financial crisis, I think even more serious than the one we have had in the European Union. But because they remained independent, they kept their sovereignty, and they didn't rely on others to get out of the crisis. So they didn't have to pay huge interest rates. They didn't have to apply this very significant austerity measures, even if they did on their own decide to have some austerity. And more importantly, you know, they brought the people who created this crisis to account. And I'm referring specifically to the bankers. You know, they didn't go out and bail out the banks as the EU has been doing around the European Union. They let the banks collapse. Banks that weren't doing well just were allowed to collapse. They also brought many people to court, including the Prime Minister, who was there between 2006 and 2009. He was not punished, but he was prosecuted. So, and they found themselves the solution to the problems. Okay, today they cannot say that they are out of the crisis, but they can say that they see the light at the end of the tunnel. Whereas here in Europe, in the rest of Europe, we cannot say the same, really. If you compare the situation that Iceland has today and had some years ago, and the situation that Greece has. I think it is clear that Iceland has succeeded in their approach to the crisis, whereas Greece will be paying for, let us say, the help that the European Union has given to them for a long time, and the people are really suffering. Considering, you know, what we have seen around Europe and how the European Union has dealt with the crisis, I would really, really advise Iceland not to ever join the European Union. They can have the benefits of this union with other type of arrangements, but they should never fall into the trap. European Union was angry when they stopped the accession talks, and they have even stopped the grants that they were giving to this country. I mean, I don't think the people in Iceland should be scared about this. I'm sure that the European Union is going to try to impose sanctions and whatever they can to force these people into coming to the Union, but I think they should stand firmly against this, against membership of the Union, and I'm sure that in a few years they will congratulate themselves for the decision.